Hello, my name is Paul Arnold. I serve as a chaplain here at Glacier Hills Senior Living. Thanksgiving is coming up, and I know for many of us, Thanksgiving will not be the same this year. It's been a difficult year, and yet I believe through faith and through prayer, we can find perspective, we can find joy, and I want to share with you these prayers and poems that have blessed me. When I was a young father of two small children, I went back to seminary to work on my doctoral degree. And I went to a seminary that also offered online learning, and I found it too impersonal. So I arranged with my wife and the church I was working with to travel to Atlanta, Georgia for 3 weeks a year to study with my colleagues, my friends, and to be there in person to listen to some amazing teachers. Two professors that really impacted me were Stephen Olford, a British pastor, evangelist, and Ron Owings. Both these men traveled together into revivals and conferences, and they spoke about the theology of worship. And what they taught me really stayed with me, and I read the Psalms so much differently because of them. Ron Owings wrote in his book, Return to Worship, "Worship is the response of an adoring heart to the magnificence of God. In the truest sense of the word, it is the occupation of the created with the Creator himself." Olford summarized it this way, "Great theology married to great hymnology rises to God in great doxology." I like that very much. And so our first prayer is from the Bible, Psalm 100. Psalm 100, "Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him, and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations." Our second prayer is being thankful for food. Like many believers, I was taught as a child to say grace for the food or prayer over the food we would eat. At times, we would simply say, "Thank you, Lord." And my wife today has a standard prayer or grace that includes, "Thank you for this food which nourishes my body. May your spirit nourish my soul to do your will." My brothers growing up, and I had two older brothers, used to like to say funny prayers like, "Good food, good grief, let's eat," or, "Good bread, good meat, good God, let's eat." But this one I thought was very funny. "Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, whoever eats fastest gets the most." Food is so basic, and yet it's so key for community. And I know I enjoy a good meal, but I enjoy it much better when I eat it with others. We should remember that God is always with us at every meal that we eat. This prayer comes from an unlikely source, Robert Duvall, who's an actor. And he said this prayer in the movie 7 Days in Utopia. In the movie, Duvall's character, Johnny Crawford, is a wise old rancher who helps a troubled young man. At dinner, Crawford says a brief but poignant prayer that we'll read now. "For food in a world where many walk in hunger, for faith in a world where many walk in fear, for friends in a world where many walk alone, we give you thanks, O Lord. Amen." Thankful for creation. I'm going to focus on a man named Walter Rauschenbusch, who was born on October 4th, 1861 in Rochester, New York, to immigrant parents from Germany. Rauschenbusch went through a rebellious period as a teenager, but he came to a point of believing in God, and he said, like the prodigal son, he came to his father and he prayed for help and he received it. Rauschenbusch graduated from the University of Rochester in 1884 and the Rochester Theological Seminary of the American Baptist Churches in 1886. In 1886, he started his first pastorate at Second German Baptist Church in Hell's Kitchen, New York. There he experienced urban poverty, he led funerals for children, and it made him realize that the church had an essential role to fight against systematic injustices among all groups and for each person. In 1897, he started teaching at the Rochester Theological Seminary, and he wrote two books that influenced many people, Christianity and the Social Crisis and A Theology for the Social Gospel. He died in 1918 at the age of 56, and he wrote many big words, but it's this one prayer, a wonderful prayer, not of activism, but about the beauty of creation that really resonated with me. I know whenever I go outside, God's creation gives me a sense of thankfulness. Oh God, when I have food, help me to remember the hungry. When I have work, help me to remember the jobless. When I have a home, help me to remember those who have no home at all. When I am without pain, help me to remember those who suffer. In remembering, help me to destroy my complacency, bestir my compassion, and be concerned enough to help, by word and deed, those who cry out for what we take for granted. Amen. Thankful for community. As a boy growing up in a traditional Presbyterian church, I loved traditional hymns, especially around the holidays, Thanksgiving and Christmas and Easter. One hymn that is known for faith and community and Thanksgiving is the hymn, We Gather Together. We Gather Together is a Christian hymn of Dutch origin written in 1597. It was written at a time when the Dutch were engaged in a war of national liberation against the Catholic King Philip II of Spain. Wilt heden no treden is the Dutch translation of We Gather Together. And it resonated for the Dutch because they were forbidden to gather for worship under the Spanish king. This hymn steadily gained popularity, especially around Thanksgiving, when it was included in the Methodist Episcopal Church hymnal in 1935. For me, this hymn is a testament that God's people should meet together, live together, stand together for God's greater calling to love God and to love each other. I miss singing with a group of believers. Whenever we would do that, I would feel so encouraged. So now, even when it's even just two or three of us, we can still feel encouraged and know there's power of community and there's power through the Spirit of God. We gather together to ask the Lord's blessing. He chastens and hastens his will to make known. The wicked oppressing now cease from distressing. Sing praises to his name, he forgets not his own. Beside us to guide us, our God with us joining, ordaining, maintaining his kingdom divine. So from the beginning, the fight we were winning, thou Lord west at our side, all glory be thine. We all do extol thee, thou leader triumphant, and pray that thou still our defender wilt be. Let thy congregation escape tribulation, thy name be ever praised. O Lord, make us free. Amen.
We gather together to ask the Lord's blessing. He chastens and hastens his will to make known. The wicked oppressing now cease from distressing. Sing praises to his name, he forgets not his own. We all do extol thee, thou leader triumphant, and pray that thou still our defender will be. Let thy congregation escape tribulation, thy name.
thankful for family and friends. Occasionally, I look at YouTube.com to see a variety of videos that people put out there. In fact, we have our videos from Glacier Hills on there as well. If you search Glacier Hills Senior Living and then click on the Uploads button, you'll see all of about 100 videos. But this video really struck me because it was sung by Mary Chapin Carpenter, and the songs were so great, and it focuses on the theme of loving kindness. I know that we're not able to be with all the family we want to be this Thanksgiving, but we should be grateful that we have those relationships already, that those are the relationships that binds us together, and we should be grateful for them.
Grateful for each hand we hold, gathered round this table. From far and near we travel home, blessed that we are able. Grateful for this sheltered place, with light in every window, saying, welcome, welcome, share this feast, come in away from sorrow. Father, mother, daughter, son, neighbor, friend, and friend, in the gift of loving kindness. Grateful for what's understood and all that is forgiven. We try so hard to be good, to lead a life worth living. Father, mother, daughter, son, let grateful days be endless. Grateful for each hand we hold, gathered round this table.
During Thanksgiving, we usually look around and think about what we're thankful for. Yet when we're honest with ourselves, we also think about the people who are not at the table anymore. People who have died and gone down to heaven. People maybe we were estranged from. But that is a time of loss during Thanksgiving. And so I found two prayers here that talk about loss and realizing that even through loss, we can have times of bittersweet memories, being thankful for that person being in our life, being hopeful that we will see them whether on this earth or the next. For flowers that bloom about our feet, Father, we thank thee. For tender grass, so fresh, so sweet, Father, we thank thee. For the song of the bird and hum of the bee, for all things fair we hear or see, Father in heaven, we thank thee. For blue of stream and blue of sky, Father, we thank thee. For pleasant shade of branches high, Father, we thank thee. For fragrant air and cooling breeze, for beauty of the blooming trees, Father in heaven, we thank thee. For this new morning with its light, Father, we thank thee. For rest
and shelter of the night. Father, we thank thee for health and food, for love and friends, for everything thy goodness sends. Father in heaven, we thank thee.
Thankful for perspective. My parents were children in the Great Depression. Each night at my mother's home, my grandfather would stand at the end of the table with a serving pot or dish. He would ask for the plates to be passed to him to the front. He would put the food on the plates and he would serve himself last. My grandfather would then say grace and they would eat, and this was their tradition. But it was my father's way to make sure, my grandfather's way, to make sure his family had enough food first before taking food for himself. We have so much these days. I have never been hungry at night or wondered where I would sleep. This time of virus is difficult, but difficult times give us perspective, much like the next prayer written by Reverend Samuel Pugh. In 1972, Reverend Pugh became the editor of World Call magazine and was a poet. His books of poetry were on the New York bestsellers list, and you can still buy them on Amazon.
Oh God, when I have food, help me to remember the hungry. When I have work, help me to remember the jobless. When I have a home, help me to remember those who have no home at all. When I am without pain, help me to remember those who suffer. In remembering, help me to destroy my complacency, bestir my compassion, and be concerned enough to help, by word and deed, those who cry out for what we take for granted. Amen.
Thankful for beauty. Many of you recognize the name of Ralph Waldo Emerson. He wrote so beautifully. He was a man of letters and words, and so for Thanksgiving, I really like this poem he wrote. It's a prayer as well.
For flowers that bloom about our feet, Father, we thank thee. For tender grass, so fresh, so sweet, Father, we thank thee. For the song of the bird and hum of the bee, for all things fair we hear or see, Father in heaven, we thank thee. For blue of stream and blue of sky, Father, we thank thee. For pleasant shade of branches high, Father, we thank thee. For fragrant air and cooling breeze, for beauty of the blooming trees, Father in heaven, we thank thee. For this new morning with its light, Father, we thank thee. For rest and shelter of the night, Father, we thank thee. For health and food, for love and friends, for everything thy goodness sends, Father in heaven, we thank thee.
Thankful for a relationship with God. Jesus walked with his disciples for 3 years, and they had a close relationship. And he shared with the disciples what he knew of his Father and what it was like to live close to God in a relationship. And when he was asked how to pray, Jesus gave the disciples the Lord's Prayer. Sometimes we say it quickly, sometimes we don't realize its beauty, but at any Thanksgiving, I think we always should say the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you for joining me through these prayers that are important at Thanksgiving and really any time in our life. I hope you take time not only to say words to God, but to be quiet and to listen to God in your time of prayer. And then praying with other people is sweet as well, whether it's in person or over the phone. God bless you this day.